Channel switch.
Hello.
Hi, Soren. Timo.
Tim.
Hi, John. Richard. Soren. Timo.
User joined your channel.
Good evening.
And Geert. Hi.
Hi, Geert.
Hi, Geert.
Hi.
Wow, we're flying Slovenia today.
Yeah, it's funny. The other day I was actually thinking, why aren't we ever flying to Slovenia? And, well, there we go.
Well, yeah, everybody has that scenery.
So you better be fast to get on the first level?
I think so. I also chose Slovenia as the first task for Eurobattle.
Okay.
User joined your channel.
I think I dropped off too early there. But there's some, I think you're going to go through a thermal now.
Yep, I just hit it right there.
frame rate is a bit low.
Yeah, I noticed that too.
Yeah.
Oh, they shouldn't be in this scene.
Yeah, I know. I think this is some kind of multiplayer thing. Because I don't know if this is kind of ever happening when I'm playing single player tasks, but. Yeah, like right now, it smoothed out a lot for me, but as I turn around different directions, I mean, towards the airport, it's worse. I don't know.
And what's your frame rate, John?
It's bouncing around like 50 seconds. Okay, wait. It's like now it went up to 60, which is, it's the highest it'll go. Yeah, now
okay.
As I'm circling, it's 60.
100,
yeah. Yeah, it's out. It just completely smoothed out. Totally now. Yeah, my monitor is a plain old fashioned monitor with maximum refresh rate of 60.
Yeah, 60 is enough.
What's the frame rate button again?
Shift D.
Yep.
And then you can hit D again to set the chat back to the normal mode. Yeah, so I don't know why it suddenly smoothed out. I mean, we're still I can still see the airfield completely. I don't know what changed.
Oh. Yeah, mine has smoothed out as well. Hey, that cloud is over there. The feeling I'm in the wrong place.
Probably just a different thermal.
Yeah.
There are our clouds starting now.
Oh yeah. Is it 2000 star time?
Cloud playing is not allowed, Richard.
Yeah. Did I go in?
Oh, short prior looks like.
No, you're fine. You didn't get the only.
Jordan is behind.
Yeah, it was just. That was the easiest way. We were both at the same altitude, so I was just following you, Richard. Not, I wasn't actually trying to circle. I mean, I was just sticking behind you the whole time.
Okay.
Yeah, 2000 is the star height.
Yes.
Cloud base, so that's actually nice.
Yeah.
User joined your channel.
Good evening.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Robert.
I'm on the second server.
I have to be quick these days.
Yeah.
Is it full?
No, 26.
Almost 7 meters a second on this one. With the ridge and the cloud.
Yeah.
I like the Slovenian scenery. I like, but I know it's not using your real, it's not using actual aerial photos, it's using the, you know, generated, but.
It's pretty good.
Looks like it gets like the little villages actually have houses and stuff in them.
Not a regatta or anything, is it?
I think it's like 20 minutes.
And I was just looking at an interview with Sebastian Kawa, and he's describing playing in a competition in Kiwi, and they're flying duodiscus, and he's flying with a different one every day as co-pilot. And he's not flying himself, he's just advising. And he's winning. So his conclusion is that it's not how you fly, it's where you fly.
I'll be right back.
What the fuck happened?
I think John is busy.
Okay, disconnect.
Someone flew right. Oh, dang it! Someone flew right into me. Head on.
Ouch.
Me and someone else had a head-on collision.
Oh.
And now I can't connect back up, so I need to go to the second server, which I don't have on my list. Great.
Ouch. Yeah, I'm starting to use Tim's tactic of going off and finding somewhere else to fly in the beginning.
Yeah.
I understand that Sebastian has flown very much Condor also.
Has he?
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. So I haven't. This it's an hour and a half. This interview. So he's being interviewed by Bruno, or at least Bruno is in the conversation.
Yeah. I've seen it.
You've seen it. Okay.
But he was interviewed once, along with his sailplane on the airstrip, and he said, "Well, something about just fly a lot of Condor."
Great.
Then you will be good.
Yeah, Bruno was flying Condor, not Sebastian, or?
I don't know.
I think Bruno Vassel is flying, was flying Condor, not Sebastian Kawa.
Yeah, Sebastian also.
Ah, okay.
He says it in an interview.
I know the German guy, Sebastian Nagler, Nagler. Was flown Condor. User joined your
channel. Hi, good evening.
Hi, Uwe.
Good evening.
Hi. Yeah, I think it stands also on the home site for the Condor itself.
Okay.
As an advertisement.
Okay.
I suppose that collision was, well, I mean, when two people collide head on, I guess technically it's both people's fault.
Yeah.
I was playing around flying inverted along the ridge because there was no lift to keep your altitude, and someone else came at me right in front. We hit each other. I was inverted and he was right side up. But we were both flying straight, so.
Yeah. The same as the ship's rules.
But the rule is, don't worry, the other ship will turn.
You know, after we got GPS, collisions. The famous, you know, before you had radar-assisted collisions, now they had GPS-assisted collisions. Because everybody was plotting between the same two points across an ocean.
Oh, then going exactly the same course.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, the GPS is more than accurate enough to get two ships, considering how big ships are now.
Yeah. Luckily, we didn't have GPS when I was at sea.
Let's see, I use the Lorian or other.
Yeah, Lorian, Decca, DF, Sextant.
You have seen that movie, or not movie, but YouTube film, which they are on a US carrier or something, and
approaching a lighthouse.
Yeah, approaching a lighthouse.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a classic joke. There is the telling them that they have the right of way in the lighthouse. It's like, I don't think so.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's a little bit typical Americans also, I guess. I don't know. Be a little bit stubborn. I don't know, but
yeah, well, if you're on a big ship like a
yeah,
you expect everything else to get out of the way. I mean, there are lots of situations where if you're on a big ship, you just can't maneuver. And you just have, everything else has to get out of the way. And I know from experience that you're not very arrogant in that situation. You're just praying that people just move. It's going to be a shame to burn off all this height.
How high do you get to?
Which height do you have?
27 right now.
Oh, to the wave?
No, I think it's just ridge lift.
Okay.
No, I think it's not wave, this task. It's just touching.
I didn't change the trim.
What trim did you want?
Oh, I had like a -3. And then I didn't change it when I logged in over here, so I'm having to pull the stick a lot further to circle.
Right.
Thank you.
Do you think we'll have ridge lift on the first two legs and then some thermaling on the last leg?
Yeah.
Something like that. What's the weather like in Denmark, Tim? Because I suspect we're going to get it in a couple of days.
Oh, it's mild right now.
Yeah.
We had a few days with a minus 10 to minus 15 degrees during the night.
Yeah.
But now it's very mild and foggy.
Yeah, temperature's gone up here as well. I think we're at minus 9 now. 9, 11.
Yeah, some days ago it was minus 13 here on the west coast.
Oh dear.
It's very cold here on the west coast.
Yeah, it's very cold because of the humidity.
Yeah.
Yeah, good to all.
Yeah, good luck.
Okay, thanks.
Good
to all.
Yeah, good luck. Yep, good tour. Yep, I'm about to start myself.
threat him.
Yeah, go to it.
Yeah, go to it.
Duck. Good luck all.
Thank you.
Yeah, good luck.
Vielen Dank, Punk. Yeah, he flies very direct. Let's see how it works out for him. I don't think the wind is strong enough for it, but let's see. It is funk. Das ist perfekt Dänisch. I guess Google Translate is not so bad between Danish and German, as long as you keep short sentences. Yeah, he's a little bit lower, but remember he's flying the LS4. Without water the ASW20 is way better. Well fitted.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Congrats.
I just turned right as you were saying that too.
Congrats, Tim.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tim. Oh, congrats.
Congrats, Tim.
Same demo.
Yeah, congrats.
Great.
Thank you. Thank you.
The calculated wind in XC4 is a lot different from the PEA.
Okay.
Do you have XC4 set to use the external source? Because if it does, it'll just use the briefing wind.
Okay.
Yeah, for some reason, the Condor, basically the wind that Condor outputs through the serial data is just the wherever the briefing set to. It isn't updated.
Yeah, if you turn one and in Condor. The access order will update.
Yeah.
So if you fly straight for a long time, it won't update until you take some 360s.
Yeah, I think that's
or you can set it up as zigzag and oxels also, and both 360 and zigzag.
Yeah, I'll have to experiment with that, I think.
Yeah, I always turn the external wind off and just use its internal, the circling and zigzag.
Yeah, me too.
Sorry, this big cloud eyes looked at going, I'm gonna try to climb there when I get there. And a few seconds later, every glider is basically already there circling it.
Yeah.
Flock.
Yeah, if I remember, I assume we're all pretty close to the same spot. It's on the kind of low ridge head towards next turn point.
Yeah.
There's a particularly big cloud right at the end of that ridge.
Yeah, I didn't reach it.
Oh, I see you're a little bit off to the to the south there.
Yeah. I found a thermal a little bit more south, but not so very strong, or 4.3.
I'll see if this one is when I get to it.
Yeah, good, Richard.
Three.
No, okay.
Oh, yeah, that one was like 2.5 or 3. So, wherever you got the Robert might actually be better than what everybody else was at.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a blue thermal.
Yeah, I might keep on going and hope I find something better. Wait, hope I find something better. The famous last words.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Followed by, why didn't I take that last one?
Yeah. The cloud just started to form when I was on the top.
It's about 3.
Okay.
The thermals are supposed to be strong.
Yeah.
So I've been flying to 3-4. I've had plenty that were at least 4. And so I'm definitely good enough to get to those next clouds. High enough.
Yeah, the reach on start were actually good, but after you started, all lift disappeared.
Yeah, I found one that was about 5 almost, but I didn't climb. I wasn't very far below the base, so I just took a few turns in it.
It is coming up to 4-3 by me.
That's good. I've never had it that good. Maybe I'm circling too fast. Best I had was 3.4, I think.
Oh, there's a new one here, right here too.
At 4-4, you know.
That must be getting better.
So my headset was empty. Go to the Akku.
Yeah. Thank you, Oscar. I'm very good. How are you? And yes, Matt Skyper, it's the building scenery.
Settle for a 3.3. That's
the new one which you mentioned.
Yep. Yeah, the one before it was 3, just a real steady 3, and this one's really steady 3.3. Oh well.
Yeah. This one at the third point is 3.1.
Congrats.
Thanks.
Congrats.
Congrats, Robert.
Yep, congrats.
Yep, congrats.
Congrats, Tim.
Thank you.
That's
excellent.
CG.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So Lucas-san and Timo.
Timo.
Congrats.
Yeah, Sven. Congrats, Richard.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Congrats.
CG.
Congrats.
Yeah.
Congrats, Kev.
Congrats.
Yeah, Doug.
Congrats.
I don't understand what's up with all these horrible thermals.
Yeah?
This one's barely three. I mean, with empty gliders. With strong thermals, we should be like.
Yeah, I don't know how to fly this LS4 without water.
Well, Tim. You can give us some advice.
I feel it's sinking a lot in 200.
Yeah, yeah. No, I'm just using the speed to fly. I'm not using that. So I just go whatever the speed of fly says is the best speed for. I had been flying MacCready 4, I went down to 3.3. I'm just going down to 3 or.
Yeah, speed to fly and accessor, you mean?
Right, that was the Condor. The little, red or blue arrow on the U-Vario.
Yeah, mine's saying that speed to fly is around between 150 and 160.
Yeah.
Red arrow, you have to explain that.
On the E-Vario, on the little arrow, the little arrows that go up or down on the right side of the electronic Vario, is the speed of flight indicator.
Yeah, you mean when you press control?
Wait, it's speed voice the same. That one always shows the same. The little vertical arrow that goes up and down, that always is the same as.
Okay. Yeah. So that's speed of flying, okay.
It'll bounce around when you switch between cruise and climb, but once it stabilizes back again, it'll still be the same thing.
Yeah, okay. So that's what this means. I was thinking that maybe I'm in a airstream which just goes up and down. I never understood that one, but thank you.
Yeah. The arrow, the regular Vario needle, when you're in cruise mode, basically it's the same thing. You know, it'll speed of flight too.
Yeah.
But when you're in climb mode, that one will also do speed of flight. Yeah, I'm just kind of disappointed in these thermals so far.
Yeah, as long as it's the same for everyone.
That everyone else is finding that the 6 meter per second ones.
Yeah, fuck it up.
At least there's plenty.
I think, DGT must have found something like that. Oh, okay, a bit slower now.
Oh yeah, he was really high. I mean, he's still doing pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course I can, Matt Schreiber. Thank you. But I like to turn counterclockwise. I think most pilots do. Yeah, thanks, Ben. I was too low. Thank you.
I guess one reason the thermals are so weak is it's only 12:30.
No.
Nope. Yeah, and you've got quite a lot of cirrus.
Yeah, I can actually check to see if that does anything. There's a difference between saying... Yeah, it should, but I don't know if it... Never actually checked.
Oh,
THD crashed.
Oh,
who?
DGT crashed. He must have been flying a little too aggressively. Hit trees. Yeah.
Thank you.
Very nice, Timo. You are fast.
Yeah. Yeah, to do
huh?
Yeah, congrats.
Congrats, Tim.
Congrats, Tim.
Oh dear.
Those damn trees.
Yeah.
But you finished and then hit a tree?
Yeah, I'm pretty close to the airport. I could hike there if I was able to walk. Very nice, Timo.
Ja, ganz schön schnell.
Yes, that was a bad landing, Adam. But funny.
You got your part.
Thanks.
What?
Yeah,
that's the red one. That's...
Congrats. You're on the other server, huh?
Yeah.
Congrats,
everyone.
Congrats.
Yeah, congrats.
Congrats.
Yeah, you too.
Congrats, John.
Thanks.
Congrats.
Yes, congrats.
Congrats.
Refritted.
Thank you.
Congrats, Richard.
Congrats.
Congrats.
So, what is your speed?
129.1.
The LS4 or?
Yeah, LS4.
Okay.
So, there's a lot of LS4s that beat me.
We had Cirrus at 128.5.
That's pretty good.
The top place so far is a 147.4.
Our top one is an ASU20 with 169.2. No, sorry. 151.1.
It's still pretty good. Yeah, 131.1 in the LS4.
Very good. Our best LS4 was 138.3. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to think about what I'm doing. In the last 4 or 5, 6 races, I've been pretty consistently halfway down.
But, Richard, I guess that counts for all aspects of your life?
Except age.
Yeah. Don't think about that.
All right, I sleep standing up.
As long as you don't sleep hanging upside down from the rafters, you're okay.
Yeah, otherwise I was taking that from Batman. Yeah. You want to watch the America's Cup?
Sailing?
Yeah. Yep.
No, just clips.
Yeah. I try to watch it when it's on, but I always forget when they start racing. So basically, it tends to be I'll just accidentally see a video on YouTube mentioning something that happened during it. I was like, oh, I forgot the racing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's mostly, is it foils now, basically?
Yeah, I kind of. I was going to say, that's what. I'm not really. It's getting to the point where why do they even have crews on the ship? Just take everybody off and make it run by a robot.
Yeah.
That's what it could make me more. The U.S. ship capsized the other day.
Yeah, I think I saw. I didn't see it. Yeah, maybe it did. I think I saw a clip of that. I'm just waiting for them to get rid of the sails and start using parachutes and sort of paragliders instead.
Oh, very close guess.
Yeah.
Very good.
You'll do it. You can do it.
Yeah, there was a video of one of these things capsizing, which was rather dramatic looking.
Congrats again. Very nice.
Congrats.
Yeah, thank you.
Congrats.
And now to the airport.
Yeah.
I would say no.
Thank you.
I crashed in the trees. Too. You can make a perfect landing. No gear.
Gear down.
No. No gear down on crash landings. Oh, very nice, kid.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah, I guess
so. You saw the vintage Spitfire landing with an engine failure?
Yeah, I saw. Yeah, not Spitfire, it was an Yak, I think.
Okay. And he didn't extend his gear for he wanted a short run.
I don't know what you're
talking about. I think he wanted to stay on.
You think it was in Spitfire or Yak 52?
There's multiple videos of both lines, but I one of the one Tim's talking about, yeah, he kept his gear up.
Okay.
Yeah, intentionally.
Yeah.
I think Mad Skyper, the best plane is. It depends on the weather. The more rich you have?
No, I mean, if you put that thing over on its back, you get smashed, wouldn't you?
You should go for a lower handicap, maybe a Cirrus, an LS4 or ASW19. But if it's mostly thermals, like today, a lot of thermals, I think the ASW20 without water is the best. Keep in mind
that second link is the one Tim's talking about.
We can't hold any water in club class. with the water, the LS4 is actually very nice.
Yeah, I say goodbye. Thanks for flying together. I go to meal.
Yeah, I'll say bye as well.
Yeah, ciao.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, everyone.
Okay, bye, everyone.
Yeah.
Bye. Ciao.
User disconnected from your channel.
Åh, Søren, du er snart i mål.
To minutter og 37 sekunder, så er jeg der.
Jeg venter lige på dig. Det ser tak, fint ud. Du har da god højde på.
Ja, så altså, den røde kugle, den ligger dernede, hvor den skal.
Super. Yeah, in my opinion, Matt Skyber, you should go for the LS4 because it's also very competitive against gliders in all. You know, against the EB or any other gliders. If you have a lot of rich, the relatively low handicap and the amount of water the LS4 can carry, it's a very good plane.
User disconnected from your channel.
The Libelle is not very competitive, but it's a very beautiful glider.
Alright, bye-bye. Have a nice evening.
You too.
Yep,
and congrats.
Yep, have a good evening.
Disconnected from your channel.
For the 15 meter class, I think the Diana is very nice, but it's hard to handle in the thermals. Maybe I would say the Ventus is a good choice.
Yeah, so
congrats, son. Very nice.
Tak, tak.
Yeah, then you should definitely consider the Ventus.
Jamen, så kan vi jo godt tillade os at komme ud og få noget mad.
Ja, langt om længe.
Jamen, tak for i dag. Vi høres.
Ses. Ja, det gør vi. Hej Søren. Ha' det godt.
Hej. Jo.
Disconnected.